What's going on, fellow gamers? Welcome back to another Pro Guides video. So, after all this time, and after the longest and arguably the most bland season we've seen yet, updates have finally resumed and the game really seems to be looking up for the most part, okay? But one major change has come into play, and that's mostly like, you know, going to send us all into grind time once again, and that is the full hard reset of everyone's arena points. So, in this video, we're gonna be showing you how to reach Champions Division in Arena easily, so you don't have to stress over your points any longer than you have to. But real quick, ladies and gentlemen, my favorite part, it's time to do the question of the day. Here we go. Today's question is, how many arena points are you shooting for this season? Maybe you're trying to push as high as possible, or, you know, maybe you're content with just getting contenders or 6,500 points just to get into champs. I don't know. Let us know down in the comments because we are really curious to find out. What's going on, guys? It is your motivation guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. I am back to encourage you to be unstoppable, not only in this game, but also in life. But you have to change your negative mindset into a positive mindset. Think positive about yourself. Think positive about your future. And I promise you, you're gonna see a huge change in your life. I am your number one fan. Go and get it. Last thing before we get into this amazing video, if you want to improve and maybe even reach a pro level, you need to check out ProGuides.com. Okay, so on our website, we offer courses from some of the best pros like Mongrel and Benji. And we're creating new ones weekly, from advanced building and editing guides to scrim courses to controller courses and so much more. We also have a ton of articles and guides to help you guys stay on top of the meta. Finally, on top of all of this, we offer 24/7 on-demand coaching to help you guys improve. If you want to be the best, you got to check out ProGuides.com. All right, guys, it's about that time. Ladies and gentlemen around the world, it's time to scream this out. It's time to sit back, come on, relax, and grab some of my favorite candy. What is that? It's that Bunch of Crunch, and let's get this going. All right, guys, so for the first tip on this list is to grind solos. So solos are, you know, amazing for arena points, as you get 20 points per kill instead of 10 in duos, and even less in the other modes. And since the mode for this season hasn't been announced just yet, at least, you know, when this video is being written, it's best to stick to the core mode for practice as well. Okay, so in solos, it's just so much more easier because of the lack of any teammate searching. And, you know, having to search far and wide to find someone near your skill level. Placement points are easier to get in solos as well. As, you know, we all know, placement is pretty darn important in arena. Yes, I just said darn. Speaking of placement, let's talk a bit more about that. Guys, I'm not exaggerating when I say placement points are going to be everything when you're grinding for arena points. Placement points always come relatively early, and especially in the new season with all the new locations and stuff. Tons of players are gonna drop around those POIs and get killed in the early game. So if you can play for placement points and play the game mostly safe, then pop off an in-game to try and get the win, yo, that's gonna be your best strategy. All right, so think about it like this. Top 25 gets you 60 points. Top 15 is gonna get you 30. Top 5 is gonna get you 30. And the win is gonna get you 60. That's 180 points for a win, which is equal to 9 kills, which is super hard to get, especially in arena where most players are playing seriously and they really wanna win. You know, overall in arena, you know, placement points are absolutely the wave. And, you know, you should try your best to use a placement-based playstyle so that you can maximize your points. All right, so now let's get into the different stages of the game, starting with the early game. In the early game, okay, so you want to land in an isolated area, preferably an unnamed, you know, smaller spot with decent loot or the edge of a POI. Going for early game kills can be nice, okay, and you know, you can get a fair bit of extra points, but be sure to use calculated aggression. Don't just like W key if you don't get a shotgun or a good shield, if you don't have materials, you know, etc. But if you have everything you need and you're able to go for a kill safely, especially like with 20 points per kill, in solos at least, that is absolutely worth giving it a shot. Just make sure you know when to engage and when to disengage intelligently so, you know, you don't get caught up in a bad fight. In terms of your drop spot, as I said, we recommend dropping at the edge of a POI or simply just dropping into an unnamed spot or even forming a loot route out of multiple, you know, single chest spawns if that's your thing. In solos, we do recommend getting at least 5 chests. Any less, you know, and you probably won't be well kitted for the later stages of the game. Any more is great and is definitely preferable to, you know, get 7 or more chests if you're able to. Up next, guys, is the mid game. And this is where your game sense and decision making really start to impact your game. As always, you know, try to rotate into the first zone as soon as you can. If you're not in it, and stay around the edge to, you know, avoid getting into fights And if you do end up getting into a fight, at least, you know, make it a fair fight with low risk of third parties. You know, we think the definition of mid-game really, really begins around the time, you know, the first zone finishes closing. By this time, you know, you're typically kitted up and the majority of players in non-stack lobbies will already be gone. From here, and I mean like right here, sheer positioning is enough to pretty much guarantee that you get top 25 and further. All right, so when the second zones pop up, you're gonna want to immediately get in and try to go toward the middle. You don't have to be perfectly centered, but just try to get in, okay? One helpful tip is this. Don't go crazy and like ramp over someone's base if they're in the middle. If someone has alpha positioning, it's likely that they'll W key and fight for it. And this might result in both of your games being griefed. And having an opponent right under you is never preferable, so if you can avoid it, because you never know what they're gonna do. Simply just set up a brick base in second zone or just some sort of material that you can regain and wait for the third. When the third pops up, once again, rotate as early as possible, covering yourself with a few wood bills to avoid enemy fire. Get toward the center if you can. You don't have to be perfectly in the center, but try at least, you know, be toward the middle. And then simply just wait it out on a base until the fourth zone comes in, scoping around, you know, for opponents you might be able to get shots or even a kill on. When zone number four rolls around, guys, we're nearing the end game. The zone always pulls, you know, half in and half out for the fifth, so we're setting up for that. In this meta, it's safest to play edge of fourth zone and then take your changes for half in. So simply go around the edge, you know, preferably a few boxes in, and hang out there. By this point, all right, you should have top 25 or be extremely close if you're in a higher point division. You know, most players here get confused and just end up dying off pretty quickly in the next few zones. But you watch pro guys, so you're all set. Don't worry about that. I got you. Finally, when half M pops up, if it pops up on you, then you've just gotten very, very lucky, my friend. Build up some more if you're able to do so safely and enjoy your free zone. If it pulls far, simply just get up and rotate, all right? Try to go one of three routes, left, right, or middle. Whichever one is most quiet is your best bet. Simply just take the quiet route using some wood bills to cover yourself. And then once you're in the half end zone, congratulations, you've reached the end game. All right, guys, so check this out. The end game is a lot easier than it seems to be on the surface. In the end game, which is basically just, you know, the moving zones, you just want to get ahead of every single zone and look back for picks. Keep track of your health and materials, and if you ever begin running low, go for some impact frags to refresh it simply by just looking for a kill. Try to begin looking for impact frags, you know, when you've got a few hundred materials left. If you wait until zero, it's going to be too late and you're probably going to become an impact frag. And that's not what we want to happen. So it's just best to stay on low to, you know, mid ground unless you have a clear, easy opportunity for height and you have ample materials to just push for it. Preferably, you know, around 500 or 600, but it's safer if you have more. And from here, it's all about racking up those kills and getting into those placement margins. You know, there's really not much more specific advice we can give you for in-game simply because, you know, it's just so complicated and there are so many different situations that can arise at any time. With time and practice, guys, you know, you can still get better at them, but it all just comes from experience. So we hope you enjoyed this video. We hope that it helps you guys on your journey to reach Champions Division in this next season. Okay, so try your best, guys, to utilize these strategies in this video to push for placement points and play each stage of the game intelligently to maximize your points. All right, so we got to do a quick recap of what we talked about. If you're grinding solely for points, then it's best to play mostly solos for points, as, you know, eliminations get you more points and placement comes faster and easier. And it's pretty much like guaranteed if you play it smart in the early and mid game, and anything past that is pretty much extra points. Placement points are going to be your best friend when you're grinding for champs, so be sure to play for placement, especially that top 25 margin, which is going to score you 60 points. This doesn't mean, you know, to camp and just hide from everybody. If you find a fight that you can realistically win and do so safely, then by all means, guys, you got to take it. But don't make decisions that, you know, put your game at risk, at least until you have a good amount of placement already under your belt. So in early game, land at a somewhat quiet area, preferably like with seven or more chests. If you find any other players, you know, you can choose to fight based on your loot, materials, and health. If you have all three and you're comfortable fighting, then go ahead. Otherwise, simply just disengage and you gotta play safe. In the second and third zone, simply just get toward the middle and just base up. You don't have to be perfectly there, but try to get at least relatively close so, you know, you don't go into the edge and take a risk for the fifth. Finally, when zone 5 pulls up, If you have to rotate, choose the quietest path and go early. Don't shoot at players in front of you unless, you know, they're an easy shot, or else they're gonna, you know, likely just try and just hold you in the storm. If the fifth is on you, simply just base up higher if you're able to, or, you know, otherwise find a comfortable position from where you can just get angles and players below. And finally, my friends, moving into the end game. It's pretty simple. Just rotate early and get ahead of zone. If you see an easy opportunity for height and you have the materials to take it, it's just great to take it. But don't stress too much over it, okay? As in this meta, you know, height can be very risky. It's better than low ground, but it's still not preferable all the time. Really consider whether or not, you know, you should actually take it. And from here in the end game, man, it's really about your mechanics, to be real. Reaction time and ability to just pick up kills. Go for impact frags whenever you can, and just try to play it smart for more placement points when you're in a good spot, looking around for any free kills you can find along the way. And that's it. If you can follow all these tips, you're gonna be one step closer to reach Champions Division in Season 2. All right, guys, this has been a really, really fun video, but unfortunately, we're gonna have to end it right here. I hope you guys all enjoyed this video. You know, enjoy using these tips and tricks to perform better in Arena so, you know, you can keep up your grind and reach Champions Division nice and early on. Let us know in the comments what you thought about this video, along with what you'd like to see next on this channel. Remember, guys, we read every single comment and we consider every single thing you say. If you enjoyed this video, we'd appreciate it a ton and a bunch, like a bunch of crunch. If you could drop a like, consider subscribing, and also share the video with some of your friends if you think it's gonna help them out. So finally, we'll see you next time.